G'day everyone, Alex here from Paperform, and today I'm going to show you how you can automatically send your files and form submissions to Dropbox from your online forms. So let's take a look. Paperform's direct integration with Dropbox empowers you to send your forms uploaded files and results to a specific Dropbox folder. I've created a design request form which prompts submitters to provide details on their request, as well as to upload an image file and a text file. So to set up the integration from your form editor, head to After Submission, Integrations and Webhooks. Select Dropbox, next select Upload Files. You'll then be prompted to add your Dropbox account. So hit the Add Account button and then follow the prompts. Once you have successfully connected your Dropbox account, it's time to select the folder where you want your files uploaded to. So I'll select my Design Request folder. Next, you'll need to select the files that you actually want to upload. So I'm going to select the image file as well as the text file. Once you've done this, you can set a file name prefix for each of your files. And this is merely an extension of that file name. It'll be a label that precedes that original file name. You can either manually type it, or we can click on the icon that appears on the right-hand side, which will display all of the values from our form submission. For my use case, I want to precede the original file name with this submission date and time. So I'm going to select submitted at, and voila. But not to worry, you can leave this section blank. Next, we have the ability to set a file path fragment. And this is merely creating a new folder within our original folder. You may want to organize your files per customer, and this is a great use case. I would like to organize all of my design requests for each customer into a specific folder. To do this, I'm going to select that icon on the right-hand side and display the response from my submitter for their name. This will automatically create a folder specifically for that customer. However, it's best to note that if you are uploading multiple files within one integration setup, this is going to create multiple folders. If you want to organize all files for that particular customer into one folder on your Dropbox, then you must create multiple integrations for each correlating file. But of course, you must use the exact same file path fragment or folder name. After this, it's time to test the integration. But first, we'll need to run a test submission of our form. So head to the top right corner and click the eye icon there to view the live view. I'm just going to quickly run through a test submission here. I'll type a name, a company, quickly chuck in an email, then a date. Now it's time to upload the image file, specifically a PNG, and the text file. There we go. And once those files have successfully uploaded, we can hit submit. Now let's jump back into the integration setup and select send test. Okay, groovy, that test has been a success. So let's jump into our Dropbox account and I'll head to my design request folder and voila. There we can see that a folder has been created with my submission name. But if we jump into that folder, we can see what I was referring to by it creating multiple folders for multiple files. Then we can see we've got the submitted at value preceding the original file name there. And that's it. If we jump back into the integration, we can complete the setup by hitting finish setup. It's that easy. Now, if at any time, for any reason, you want to turn off your integration, toggle this here. And if you'd like to edit, look at the history, duplicate, or delete your integration, you can just click that cogwheel and make a selection. Now, I hope this has been a helpful video. If it has, please hit that thumbs up and make sure to subscribe to our channel for more helpful videos on Paperform. Good luck and have fun creating.